So this video, I will go over place values related to decimal numbers or signed numbers. And it is often useful to know the place value of each of the digits. So for example, you may want to know what place value this 5 is in. Or you may want to know the place value of this 1, or possibly maybe the 3 behind the decimal. All of these place values have a particular name attached to them. So what I'm going to do is first maybe I'll white out the decimal component here for just a second, and just concentrate on the whole portion of this. And I'll step one by one through the decimal values here. And we'll start with the first one on the right-hand side. And that place value of the number 5 right here is known as the ones, because we do count in ones. The second place value that we have, so this one right here, is known as the tens, because we start counting. Once we finish with the ones, we move over to the place value of tens. The one that follows right here is known as the hundreds. Once we finish with the hundreds, we start a new triad. Now, the word triad here, so it's a grouping of three. The first one, so this triad, has no name attached to it. The second triad, which I will highlight in different shade, so starting with the one, so that place value is known as the thousand or thousands. The one that follows, which is the seven in this case, is known as the 10,000s. And finally, completing the triad, so the word tri meaning three, so this one is known as the 100,000 place value. And that particular triad is known as the thousands triad, and you will notice the reason is because all the place values include the word thousands. So that's the thousand triad. Once you finish with the thousand triad, you will get into the million triad. So right here, you will have the millions, then you will have the 10 millions. And if we had another digit, it would have been 100 million. And then it continues on for us. If we had more digits, it would have been the billions. We have the 10 billions, and we have the 100 billions on those. So I'll just write that in briefly here. So again, this was the millions. Then it was the 10 millions. And then finally, the 100 millions. Okay, so that's what we would have here. And if we had more digits, that's what this would be. So again, you're noticing, okay, so this triad with the place values was known as the millions. And here we would repeat the same thing, except we would get into the billions. And then it would be the 10 billions, and then the 100 billion. So I'm not going to write that in. And then it gets into trillions as the next one. But primarily in numbers, you utilize these ones. These place values are of use to us. Now, of course, place values also, as I was hiding it there before, there are place values behind the decimal. So if I copy this, so I'm just going to copy this here so that I can input it. Okay, and I'll paste it back in here. Okay, so if we have that, I'll make it a touch bigger. So now, how do you call the place values behind the decimal? So the place values behind the decimal, okay, so here, they start off. Okay, so we have this one right here. Maybe I'll do it in the opposite direction. Okay, so the first place value, because we are dealing with powers of tens, so this place value is known as the tenths. And notice the th, okay? So that's what changes. The next place value that we have, so that would be the hundredths. So that's right there. And then the next place value will be known as the thousandths. And then, okay, so it continues on. So this one right here, that would be known as the ten thousandths. And you are probably noticing a pattern here. Okay, if I scroll back up here, notice that what we're doing is, okay, it's almost like we're creating a mirror image and we were going through, okay, so we had tens here, so this became tenths. We had hundreds next, this became hundredths with the th. Then it was thousands, so this became thousandths with the th. And then it would have been ten thousandths, hundred thousandths, okay, and then it would have been millions, 10 millions, and so on if we had more of these place values held here. So these place values are useful to know because sometimes we use them. Someone may say round a number to the hundredths, and if you don't know what that is, okay, then that is problematic. So this is just a short overview of place values for decimal numbers. I hope you found this useful.